Hi YouTube.
Hi.
So many of you have seen Phil's Impala in the background of many of our Driftworks videos.
Mm-hmm.
So now we thought it was a good time to show you what's gone on, what you've done.
Yeah, we did a lot of the work to this during the summer, and now it's winter, it's bloody freezing. We thought we'd just have a quick walk around because we're in the off season, no racing, and we'll show you what we got up to.
Sweet. Roll camera.
Another low car for Phil.
Yeah,
it's what we do.
This is car number four.
Car number four?
No, I think of your current collection.
I don't know.
Must be.
Some, yeah.
Probably.
Yeah,
including maybe. Race cars.
Yeah, okay.
So this is your Impala?
Yeah, this is my 1964 Chevrolet Impala SS.
SS meaning?
It's super speedy. I think it's super sports, yeah. Obviously you can tell it's a sports car. Look at the fucking size of the thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's 1964. It is, it came to me from Canada. I bought it in Canada, of all places.
British Columbia.
It is an American car, obviously. And I bought this basically on a little bit of a whim, unlike most of my cars.
Yeah, it's so, not even happened before.
Yeah, yeah. I saw it come up. It was on eBay, of all things. I think I was watching my usual sort of American programs on Discovery, Fast and Loud or something like that, and something reminded me about lowriders, and I've owned a couple before, real legit lowriders, hydraulics. Hydraulics. This is air. So yeah. this is cheating, this is old man spec.
So you've seen kid time.
Yeah,
so this is air.
Seen kid, yeah, yeah. So although it looks like a fully legit lowrider, it's actually on air and I can drive it in with some semblance of comfort.
Yeah, is that the difference then between hydraulics and air, that you keep dampers and everything?
Yeah, it is a little bit more comfortable. My President, which I guess we'll put here, that was a fully hydraulic lowrider. That was a four pump system. And I think I ramped that up to 36 volts, and it basically that means when it goes up, it fucking goes up.
Right. I shot in the air and it was like trying to knock our teeth out.
Yeah, so this is more about setting a ride height and being able to cruise, and obviously I wanted to cruise low. So when I brought it over, it was described to me as correctly actually as what it's a 10 footer. So don't look too closely. It's you know, the paint works a bit rough. But you know, stand 10 foot away.
Is this the right colour?
Not the original colour. No, I think it was white.
No, but I mean, would you?
This is one of my favourite colours. Actually, I think it's very similar to that. Not quite, but yeah.
Bit of green.
I want it to be silver ultimately, like a strong metallic silver, which I've actually painted the engine bay already. Okay. So I'll show you that in a bit. But yeah, so it came to me like that. It was a bit. It was obviously somebody's toy for about 10 years in Canada, I think. I don't think it had a massive amount of use. The engine was completely gone in it. It was a miracle if we ever got it to start. It ran that badly.
What engine was in this?
It was a small block, and I think it was a 283, and you get like two bolt mains, which is like the crap version. It was a really weak engine.
So a small block, is that?
Small block's the small one, yeah.
But is that what you've got?
So someone had taken out the original SS big block?
Well, we don't know. I'm not entirely sure what the original engine was. But yeah, it'd been messed about with. It had this, I think it was basically out of an old truck of some sort.
I don't know what the difference
is. It's still a V8, 283 cubic inch, so it's a small capacity, small block engine.
Is the Corolla a small block?
The Corolla is a big block, but it's an LS, so it's different. This is old school technology. This is the original big block, small block thing. So yeah, it had pretty terrible handling, but it had already had like the air ride done on it, and it's all relatively new, so it got decent arms on it, all the airbags, Firestone airbags, and I think it's got Vi-air pumps and all sorts of good stuff. But actually driving it, it was a proper seesaw mobile. So one of the main things that I did was stick a load of ride tech stuff on it.
We're gonna have a look.
Yeah, we'll have a look at underneath in a minute. And that's basically like stiff anti-roll bars. It didn't have an anti-roll bar at the back at all. Basically what it meant was that when you drive it, if you go around a corner, it just leans and hits the floor. So what I wanted was to be able to set it up so that I could ride real low and stable, and you know, with some element of safety as well, because it's a pretty massive thing and the brakes aren't that good.
It is gigantic. I mean, you say it's like, you know, a 10 footer, but the car is about a 20 footer, isn't it?
Well, the boot is one of my favorite, the trunk is one of my favorite dimensions, but yeah, it's absolutely massive.
It's like a small
bed. Yeah, absolutely.
Considering all of this, so apparently it weighs about 1,600 kilograms.
It's not very heavy at all, yeah, but whether that's because it's like rotted away or not, I don't know. Well, it's quite old.
No, from the factory, apparently, 3,500 pounds or something?
Yeah, it wasn't particularly heavy, but it certainly doesn't handle like a lightweight car.
No.
So, what are the wheels? Are they an aftermarket? I don't know. Prepared well.
The name will come up here.
We're well prepared for
this. They're cool though, I really like them.
Yeah, yeah. It's the correct look.
Well, this is the correct car, isn't it? This is, just to like go into like what the car is, a 64 Impala is the number, isn't it?
It is. If you're you know, a diehard geeky white boy hip hop fan like me, this is life. this is what it's all about. So obviously,
and specifically not a 60. This is a 63 shape apparently.
Is it?
Well, they're facelifted in 63.
All right. Have you been researching on the internet?
I thought, well, we may as well get some facts in the show, because otherwise we're going to be in trouble.
Oh, fuck me, that's pretty specific. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can definitely out-dork me on this.
No, because, that's it, I've got facts.
Yeah, okay, that's it. But yeah.
Oh, no, 900,000 made. There you go.
900,000?
Yeah, yeah.
And how many are left? That's the question.
Oh, God. How many are left?
Yeah.
So why did you decide to change the engine?
So as I mentioned, it was when we got it over here, it was barely running, and all of this was explained to me before I bought it, so when it turned up it was as described. I was really happy with that, but the engine was basically, it's just a smoke pit, so every time you started it, it would be lucky to start having almost no compression on a lot of the cylinders, and it just about moved around. Impala!
Have you ever taken a Chevy to the levee?
Find it strike.
Yeah. Have you ever taken a Chevy to the levee?
Funnily enough, I can't remember if I've done it.
No. How do you stall an automatic?
With very good skill.
Like they long for a young black man. Brothers hang out on the set with Yale. I sound with Uncle Sam, but two dice, that's really obsolete. I'd rather hang out on the stage and kick it to a smooth gangster beat. Cause you ain't got no time, so why waste some sun? Especially when you're over the age of 21. And while you're playing, you need to stop all that banging. Too, you need to be maxing with a hoe. Nigga sipping to brew. Standing doing dirt, that shit don't last for a
So what are you doing to this?
It's got a really weak engine in it. Tiny little small block.
For those of us that don't know, what sort of power, like?
I can't even remember, is it like 160?
Oh, so.
I think they're well weak. But this one's also not feeling particularly healthy, so I use it as an excuse to fit a 454 big block, hopefully. That's the plan anyway. We've got some bits, we're gonna start taking these bits out, throwing different bits at it, and see where we end up.
How confident are you, boss?
Oh, I'm super, super confident.
How many 1964 Impalas have you worked on before?
None. None at all.
Confident.
Yeah, well, it's only
I mean, what is the worst that could happen?
You know, slight fire burn Driftworks down, but, you know, far from that, nothing.
I'm guessing you just disconnect the transmission and pull it out that way.
Yeah, I'm not pulling it out with a tranny.
A tranny?
Yeah.
You never know, and you might need a tranny.
Is there much rat poo in this?
Much what?
Rat poo? Piss poo?
Rat poo.
Rat poo.
No.
Isn't that what they always find in Gas Monkey?
I don't know.
Just bits of animal everywhere.
Yeah, we're not doing a full restoration. We're just going to obviously see what happens as we go. If we do find any good bits of restoration, we'll hopefully clear them. But it seems
it's so good.
Yeah, other things, a lot of things seem to be in the same location as the big block.
Yeah, they did make
alternators
it pretty
on
simple.
A different side, but I might be able to use that bracket and that alternator instead.
Yeah, I guess just get it out, put them side by side, see what happens. I think we might need to either make or buy some engine mounts for the big engine. Yeah, we'll see.
Cool.
Let's do it.
Let's
do a
takeout. The man's rolling out. Swing the pro rebels one time. So feel me rain from behind. Black rain. Peace to the fans in the game. Black rain. Through the struggles and the strain. Black rain. Elements of mind. So feel the rain from behind. Black rain. Peace to the fans in the game. Black rain. Through the struggles and the strain. Black rain. Elements of mind. To feel the rain from behind. We sort of like a killer devil rebel. Get away cars on the south of the sun. It's massive. Because I get into mine, able and ready. So use a high hat steady. And we could be jetty. Teeny weeny little engine. She go by the rest of the tire wins in abundance. The ass of your money switches. Now let's move on to mental oneness. And I say to false facts, let's done this. Cause we all function as one under the sun. We'd be fools to make Armageddon come. You see my perspective to be highly elected.
So now, yeah, it's not that engine. Now it's...
Well, hang on, you don't... What was good? What?
Don't show them how to open the bonnet, they'll steal... Oh, no, they won't. Nobody's stealing that. It's so fucking massive.
Man, that's huge.
This is a 454 big block. It's not the engine you should have in a lowrider, but if I was going to change the engine in it, I might as well change it for something pretty silly. So this is...
So you've doubled the weight of the engine.
Yeah, this is where's our little forklift? You can just see our little forklift there. It's a little electric forklift. It has never ever had to deal with anything like
the old engines up on the straight.
It has to pick up this.
Yeah, we moved that that way there. This, for some reason, it was like creaking and all sorts. It's so heavy. And that's the old block there.
It is. Maybe we'll find a use for that at some point down the line.
Sure. We'll come up with something.
Difference between the two? It's a V8, so it must be like 400 horse.
Oh, now you're asking again. These are specific questions that, 2 months ago, I would have been like, yeah. But so that was, I reckon that was probably down to, if that was 100 horsepower, I'd be real surprised. That's not what it came with, but I reckon that's what we're down to.
It was broken, wasn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, and this is quick now with this in. This is dangerous quick. This is, it's got to be knocking on for like 350 horsepower, maybe a bit more.
It's so cool. Now these rocker covers and stuff as well.
Yeah.
Not period correct as such.
No, absolutely. Basically, I just wanted a bit of a stealth look to it, so...
You painted the letters red.
That's not me. But yeah, I don't mind that actually, to be fair. We just chose a load of parts at catalogue.
So still running on carbs, is it?
Carb? No, this is a fake carb, so this is an...
A fake carb?
This is an EFI, which is basically part of the magic of... how it starts on the button,
right?
Every time, it actually, it's not that.
But it still looks like a carb.
That's
and you still run a carb.
That's
air
one of the best things about it.
That's so cool.
So basically, it's a fake carb. It's got two large injectors that kind of just spray the fuel into the top with the air.
Yeah.
Normal air cleaner, and then inside it's got a module that you can basically program and tune.
Cool. It's still got a distributor as well.
Yeah, so you can replace that and with another fancy gizmo down the line if you fancy it, but we were kind of running out of time with this because we had a deadline this year, and it's part of the reason why I actually bought this car was because this year I got married and I needed a cool wedding car. So
yeah, well, what better?
Yeah,
so, and it basically made it there.
Basically,
cut to the photo of it just outside the venue.
Yeah, so we kind of got to the venue. It was basically the first drive for the car after the engine swap. There was lots of little bits and pieces that we had to change and modify as we went along. It was the first ever drive for the car, and got to the wedding venue, stopped it in the driveway there to take a couple of pictures, and it just would not restart. So yeah, we ended up all in our suits and shirts and basically getting the spanners out and trying to fix bits and bobs. And of course, Craig came to the
rescue. That's it.
So yeah.
Fired it up.
But actually, I owe a lot of credit to Ross, who did most of the work.
He did a lot whilst you were at work.
Yeah, I was away for a bit before Stag Do and stuff like that in Vegas and wedding stuff. And yeah, Ross is almost entirely responsible for having put this in. So thanks very much, dude.
Yeah, absolutely good work awesome. On that.
So going back to the fuel injection system, why did you want to change it?
Basically to make it run correctly, reliability. It bugs me when cars don't start. It bugs me when they don't run correctly. And this seemed like a really cool way to handle that and make it all run nicely. So far, touch wood, it's been a brilliant system. You type in numbers of like how many cylinders it is, what capacity it is, and then it puts a program in it, a base map in it, and
Can you remember the ECU name? Is it a special one?
It's a Holly EFI.
Cool. Yeah. Very good.
So is this
it's kind of the one of the more basic ones.
All American sort of
thing. Yeah, obviously. Yeah, stuff like that in America, it's so easy to get. So yeah.
So because it's an air ride. And it only needs one battery, this car, instead of 60.
Yeah, so the trunk in my President was full of batteries, full of truck batteries, and yeah, this is basically just a single battery as normal. And then in the trunk, this ain't very pretty, but there you go. This is where it all happens.
It's a massive tank.
Yeah, it's a big tank.
How many ups and downs do you get out of one tank?
When it's not leaking, quite a few. Yeah, we're
going. And you're running big dual air pumps.
Yeah, proper wire stuff. And as I say, I think the kit itself, the air ride kit's really good. It's obviously, I don't know what kit it is, but I think it uses Firestone airbags and stuff, which is good quality.
Well, it doesn't look that old.
No, it's like it's got no rust or anything on it. So, yeah.
But obviously, like, this is not ever going to do a bounce or anything like that. And to convert to hydraulics is a completely different, massive route, isn't it?
Start again, absolutely. Isn't it? I've got to be honest, I don't want to. Yeah. I was also 40 this year, so there you go. It's like a slippery slope to.
Yeah, go watch the old back.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's the gold detail. Gold so trims. It's just got a few little bits on it, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Just
yeah.
sort of separate it.
It ties it in with the wheels and everything else, doesn't it?
Yeah. And look at that, like, proper, like, engine turned aluminium.
Don't look too closely because it's not been cleaned for a while because it's pretty much just sat since the wedding. So we've got a small oil leak that we need to have a look at, but unfortunately it means that we have to pull the engine.
Yeah, but that'll be summer. You know, it just needs to be ready for summer.
Yep.
Oh, big question, when are you putting subs in?
Subs.
Yeah.
It's already got a stereo in it, so obviously there's a lot of space for subs or dead bodies, whichever you choose. So yeah, we'll probably do that. But actually the interior, as you can see, I'm not really a massive fan of it. It's
very American.
Yeah, it's what they call bucket seats.
Really?
I don't know what's bucket about them at all. So yeah, it's...
It does neither retain water or people.
No, so this I think I'll probably redo. I do like the shape of the seats, to be fair, but I think the leather is, or whatever it is, is...
Is this just vinyl? Yeah, that's just vinyl, isn't it?
Needs a freshen up, it needs a little bit of love and attention and sort of... I think it'll work with the rest of the car a lot better if it's sort of maybe just jet black, maybe red, I don't know. I'll get real weird.
Look how low that sill is there. That's so cool. And then we go. And the dashboard is amazing. Look at the old numbers and stuff. Goes up to 120 miles an hour. That's a bit keen, isn't it? It's probably going to be terrifying.
Really wouldn't want
to. I have a question actually about under the bonnet.
Oh.
So I know you just shut it. So. What makes these good for being low rider star vehicles? Because I just looked at this and I saw that the wishbone goes, like, the wishbone's there, basically in the engine bay.
Yeah.
Is that normal?
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know.
Because it looks like just to go lower, all you do is just cut
take a bit,
tiny
take
bits
a bit
more out of this, and you're
yeah,
off.
Yeah, I don't know, to be fair. It's I guess it's the correct sort of
answers
body
in the
on
box.
Frame. Yeah, somebody will probably tell us. In case you haven't guessed, this is quite a rare car over here.
Yeah, the knowledge is.
Yeah, the knowledge base in this room is probably.
Well,
it's probably not. That
I've used up my three facts instantly, okay, yeah, so yeah. I've.
Well, let's type some things into the internet and learn a bit, and then put it on the screen.
Do you know how many are in the UK?
Nah, there are a couple. I know that there's some. There's a couple of legitimate lowriders, like proper ones.
Yeah.
Craig's had a panel van version, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Next door with an LS in.
Yeah.
A panel van.
It's not a panel van, is it?
What's it called? It's an estate.
A wagon.
Yeah, a wagon. Yeah. That's it.
Panel van.
It's nearly the same thing.
Do you know what a van is? Talking nonsense.
So I'm thinking about the Studebaker panel van. Yeah.
More gold detailing down here.
Oh yes, essential.
Is that a private plate? Or does it just have DW in it by chance?
It was assigned, it's really cool, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a nice bit of luck. And more detail.
Pump it up.
Yeah, let's fire it up. Explain how it all works.
What's going on underneath.
So, it stores air.
In a tank.
It leaks a lot.
It'll take a minute from the point I fire it up to the point we can raise it.
Oh, but in that time, we can have a look at the computer thing.
Ah, yes, the computer. So, let's see. Starts on the button, and then we've just got a little control unit here, which has, it's also my gauges. So it's actually pretty handy, and it's not tuned yet, but...
Is that the Holley one as well?
Yeah, so that's linked, that comes with that replacement EFI carb thing, so...
Yeah.
It's a really cool little unit, and, you know, if you have this sort of thing for our tuning industry, sort of stuff that we do with, I don't know, the S15, for example, I mean, that'd
be amazing,
so
wouldn't
cool,
it?
Wouldn't it, to have something that's that easily tunable, gives you your gauge and everything, but yeah.
Kind of like
PowerFC,
but
got
updated,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it is.
Unmistakable sound, a big block, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
You can always tell. Now, also, not a column shift.
Nope.
I didn't expect that. I actually thought it was column shift.
It's just a normal automatic gearbox. I kind of can't remember what it is actually. It's something good.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet.
Oh, isn't that the drag one?
No,
he's Ross. When he had it up, he said it's. What was that? The van.
Two-speed something or other. You can tell we know a lot about it.
Two-speed with overdrive.
But yeah, we've got two switches here, and one does the rear, which as you can see goes up quite easily.
Go down again. Whoa, and up again. Very nice. Now the front end,
and then
somewhat
the
heavier.
Takes all of its charge. Since we put the big block in it, it has to have pretty much a full tank of air in the back to lift it.
That's
it's that
amazing.
Much of a difference.
Come on, son. There we go.
That's still not up.
Still
not
up. No. Right.
Stroke it a little bit more.
Yeah, stroke it a little.
It never ever goes at this ride height.
Yeah. No, this
it's
is
just
for
wrong.
Getting so, yeah. It off a mountain.
Yeah, absolutely.
So what is, what have we, what's, should we have a look underneath it and see what's been done?
Yeah, so...
Right. Get it on the run then?
Yeah, should we put it on the run?
Yeah.
Okay. Niggas I run with his gun shit. All for one and one for all. Fuck that one-on-one shit. Cheated all. But gun fights the fist ball. Snatching bags. Slinging drugs at project halls. Me versus me. Only seeing me as a threat. Hand on the guard. You smoking wet. Hell no. Should I hold a fall down and set? Fucking massive thing. I don't know if I was sure this is gonna happen. No, neither am I.
Is it just like too big to do a 3-point turn in?
It's got no power steering either. So it's a bit of a mission. Right.
Well,
it's not a Nissan.
Parking. This is your expertise.
Yeah.
You should jump in, man.
I'm not very good at the driving part.
You like driving up to the place where you park? Not how you park it.
Parked. That was easy.
Yeah. Well, had to widen that as much as it could possibly go.
It is kind of a lot wider than you think as well.
The wheelbase is gigantic.
Yeah, it is massive.
It's absolutely huge.
Yeah.
Well, if you can look at that, and then when you think that is, I'm not. That's just. It's the same there.
Yeah.
You lose it.
Silly thing.
Yeah. Reminds you of your disco days.
What were your disco days?
What were we? As in music.
Did you go to discos?
Yeah, I went to...
Was it school disco?
No, I went to university.
Under 16?
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You goffed out at uni?
Goffed out and hip-hop.
Oh. No, you did not.
Goth pop.
You did not know anything about hip-hop when you came here.
I knew a little bit of hip-hop. Early 2000 hip-hop.
I knew that...
Dre, you liked Dre, didn't you?
I knew that I liked it. Yeah. I just didn't know what I liked.
So yes, there is a little bit of an oil leak, as I said, so don't stand on that.
Yep, no.
Where's that from?
It's from here somewhere, down the back. I think it's the rear crank seal, unfortunately, which is particularly frustrating because we've made this. This is a modified
oil pan. That's one of the issues you had at your wedding, was the sump.
Yeah, oh actually, yeah, so we successfully got there just about.
You do look somewhat
we successfully got to my wedding, and I got back, parked it here, went on my honeymoon, came back, and there was basically 7 or 8 litres of oil.
That's not the,
oil,
that's not the full north. Story, though.
So somebody moved it.
No. Didn't I heard that one of your good friends,
yeah.
Bon, thought he could start the car by smashing it up and down? That's some. That's what
oh, heard. Right, yeah. What,
at the wedding?
Yeah.
That's not the case. We did go up and down a little.
Our space says.
Basically, he thought he could jiggle the starter motor somehow by making some impact to the engine.
Oh, I don't know. We didn't actually realise that this was actually hitting. We thought that it was hitting here. But yeah, the oil pan sits really bloody low on the big block engine. So actually, this is a modified oil pan with the modified oil pickup. Works perfectly, but unfortunately, yeah, the rear crank seal. Which you have to take the engine out to get to, is leaking, it seems, and it's just dripping a bit of oil.
So is that engine out to get it?
Yeah, unfortunately, but you know, Ross loves it.
Oh, I should get some of the chassis scrapes as well, yeah.
Whoa, low rider.
So, if you want to have a look from the front, I'll show you basically this bit. It did have a front anti-roll bar, but it was really, really weak. It really didn't do much. So we got this ride tech. Yeah, it's kind of, they're really cool bits and pieces. They kind of bolt on most bits. As you can see the stabs here, it's pretty comprehensive. Works really well with this kit. You can see the airbags for the air ride system here. And actually on the front as well, it had no dampers at all on the front because they go where the airbags are as standard. So it had no dampers and it used to like float so much. So again, as part of the ride tech kit that we bought, you can't see it from there, maybe just around here. You can see these really cool.
Oh yeah.
And they're Fox dampers, which is really cool as well.
So you can go off-road?
Yeah, obviously.
So the front dampers, are they, I know they're aftermarket, but have you modified all the lower arms for your...
Now I'll show you, you can just about see here is a bracket. And actually it's bolted in with big tech screws basically to give you another bracket to mount that damper off. It's really cool.
So this is all off the shelf then, specifically for your Impala?
Yeah, specifically for this car, yeah.
It does amaze me, the network of parts for any American car ever, it does make our industry look a little bit small.
And that's jacked up, like massively jacked up, so this is a bit of a weird angle. But these do not have anti-roll bars at the back as standard. So as you can see, this is, again, from the other side, you'll see this is bolted in.
So trailing arm.
Creates a new mount here.
bolts up with U-bolts to the axle, and hey presto, you've got anti-roll bar. And so again, it's got Ridetech Fox dampers at the back here, which is super short, so you can go very slammed. You can adjust it to be relatively stiff as well, so we can ride really low now without hitting.
These are literally bolt-on parts, yeah, aren't they? Like, yeah, not in the...
Absolutely. It's really cool. The only thing that I've had to do with this is a slight modification to the panhard link here, just to basically push the axle over a little bit, because at the ride height that I want to run it at, the axle was a little bit off-center.
Was the idea of America low, not your idea of low?
No, I think they like low as well, but I guess our roads around here, they're not that bad. You know, you can run quite low, and I don't mind scraping about a bit, but I also like handling. That's kind of something that's quite important to me, and it's never going to handle well.
No.
I'm not kidding myself, but it's night and day with this kit on it. It's ridiculous how cool it is.
You've only driven it properly.
I've only driven it, yes.
Driven once?
A few times, yeah. I drove it that was a relatively big journey from to the wedding and back, but that's pretty much it.
The Porsche once.
Yeah?
That's it.
Oh, yeah. And then, obviously, the second stage of doing an engine conversion was sorting out the exhaust as well. So Craig has made this fantastic system for me, which basically, from the headers down, so the headers we had to choose quite carefully because clearance is a massive issue. We've actually had to have the steering column kind of goes through one of the headers at the moment, and we're gonna have to look at that properly down the road somewhere. But yeah, basically Craig's made this cool system with flexies in it here, which allow a bit of engine movement into small silencers, and then all the way back along the weird chassis, because this is a very strange chassis on these.
So chassis,
and then down and back here, and I think it's pretty much perfect. It's the exact noise that I want, exact volume that I want.
Because the original one were tiny pipes, weren't they?
Oh, they were really bad, and it wasn't
massive bend. Cherry bombs.
Yeah. Yeah, and it was messed up as well because it'd been dragged along the floor a fair bit. But this is bigger, helps get a little bit more power out of the engine as well. And yeah, it's just nice, it's proper.
So how does an X chassis work? Like, it seems, I've never seen one before.
It's just the same as anything else. It's just a body on chassis, but this is just has it tied in here instead of two chassis routes.
Oh, right, okay.
In the car. I'm not sure why it was done, to be fair. But it certainly makes routing an exhaust interesting.
Yeah. Do you know what diff's in this, or is it just...
No, it's got no LSD, obviously. You don't have an LSD on Lowrider.
Why?
Because why? One tire fires are cool.
Baffles.
Yeah. And I think that's it, pretty much, for underneath here.
That is lowriding.
Yeah. Fake old spec lowriding.
Fake riding.
Old man spec.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, like, what are the plans for this now, then?
Get it sorted and drive it next summer. Our salted roads unfortunately mean that you can't really drive cars like this without them just falling to pieces, and it is at the stage where, you know, it was built in 1964 or 1963, and
it's almost as old as you.
Thanks.
So here's a question.
It needs some attention, needs some
it
love.
It does, it needs some love, yeah. But I have a question. So now, just as we happen to be sort of stood next to another old American vehicle,
yeah,
and I guess next to another American vehicle,
yeah,
it's starting to become quite American now. Like, what's sort of made this like resurgence of like love for American stuff?
You know, just as with everything that I love, it's about ridiculous stuff.
Mm.
And
no one does ridiculous like America.
Nah, like I think modified American stuff is definitely my area of interest. I think, you know, the 3500 HD is a relatively practical vehicle in America. I've completely
ruined
that up. It now has no steering lock.
Yeah, it's slammed into the floor.
It's actually a lot lower than it looks as well. The chassis rails are probably about 4 inches off the floor. So yeah, completely wrecked that one. This one, it's supposed to be a practical vehicle for us to do trade stands with, t-shirts and stuff like that, but it would occasionally be tasked with towing a trailer with spare cars and stuff like that as well. So having it jacked up in the air when we got it, it would tow like crap. So yeah, it's decided to get a bit of slamination.
Yeah.
It's not finished yet at all, so we'll be doing bigger tires, bigger wheels on the back, but yeah, basically it's already got We've notched the chassis. I say we, this is Ross again, who's tasked with all of my stupid shit ideas at the moment.
He's really into it.
And yeah, it's a pretty cool thing. We'll probably have a look at this in detail once it's done.
It's not too far
away. It's nice covering all the continents, kind of, really. We've got like Japan, America, and have we got anything English?
I need something British. I do love the idea of having an old E-Type or something like that. I could you know, take to
French Riviera.
Yeah.
The thing is, would you ruin that as well?
I don't think I would with something like that. I definitely wouldn't be scared to modify it, so I wouldn't be scared to do, you know, the correct
but a 1J
treatment.
Not a 1J, no. But yeah, I do
that
the
is a cool car, though. Let's not mess around. That is an awesome car.
Yeah, I'm not that bothered about cars that are just there to be an investment or stuff like that. I like messing about with stuff, so yeah. I mean, whatever I did, it would probably
as it says on your hat, car idiot.
Car idiot.
But that's it, isn't it? Like, we see the line, we cross it, and we ruin it.
ruining
cars every day.
But yeah, making kind of cool things.
Making cars fun. And nothing is more fun than a lowrider. I remember, like, when we went out many years ago in your president, and everybody just smiles. Everyone just loves it.
I mean, yeah, cars like this. It's weird. I've pulled up alongside a police car with a full hydraulic car and popped next to them, and I've had thumbs up from policemen.
Yeah.
Things like that. And you know, it's just a different thing, isn't it? I had a lady on one time we went out. It was like Broad Street of all places, a terrible place in Birmingham. Don't go there if you're ever visiting.
Unless you watch football.
No, definitely don't do that either. And don't watch football. That's for baddies.
For some people.
This woman literally saw us coming. She hitched up her skirt and ran down the road after us, like screaming. Just like thought it was the coolest thing ever. So the lowriders definitely they bring out the best in people.
Yeah, they do.
Hitching up skirts and screaming.
Exactly. In which case,
that wraps it up. If you want to see more about this car, you actually have started a build thread.
Yeah, I've done a bit on it. I need to book up my ideas a little bit and bring it up to speed. But yeah, we've got the build thread on the Driftworks forum. You could probably find it just by typing in Impala. There's not going to be too many Impalas in the search boxes for that. We'll sort of keep you up to date with the other stuff that we've got going on as best as possible as well. We've got a few projects always going on, haven't we? And even though it's winter at the moment, Ross is always busy. Craig's still tasked with like a massive list of stuff that I've got to get on with.
And we've still got Rich and Martin as well doing things to their car. So
absolutely.
Plenty of content coming your way.
Do want to know anything about this or any of our other cars, or actually, if you want to educate us a little bit, because to be fair, you know, it's not a car we know a great deal about, other than it's cool.
Yeah.
And, you know, I've bought a few bits for it. So feel free to educate us, tell us we're dicks, whatever. I don't care.
It's good. It's what it's all about.
Yeah,
learning is good learning.
Yeah, man. Peace.
Well, thanks very much, everybody. Bye.
Holograms are who I am, coordinates mad data. Living day to day, the grim reap around the way. The devil in me tells me to accumulate the wealth. The head on me tells me now to keep it on the stealth. My life be inflicted with the bid that I did for the ears. Kids be asking me what precinct. As if I was hand, but some time to meet stink.